Newts to the news!
A lot of people tonight, so don't run. Just walk in nice and slowly, right? Okay, take it nice and easy. No, don't run, don't run. Okay. Hey.
John.
Slowly, slowly.
Yeah, take it, slow it down. Take it easy. There are seats, you just gotta
maybe
go find
there.
Them right
there's
now.
There's two right over there, you guys. Come on, sit down, guys.
Just fill it up. Okay. Bula! This is a great sight to see. It's great that you're all here. All right, X-Men 2, right? Say it, X-Men 2. All right, X-Men 2 it is.
When I got out of film school, I wound up working in exhibition on the front lines in movie theaters.
There's a repeat showing of this movie on Friday, all right?
And here I am again at the 180 Meridian Cinema, cramming 288 people into those 288 seats, just like it's 20 years ago. It's the best feeling in the world.
We spent so much of our life standing in back of movie theaters watching movies together. You know, that's what we do, is helping movies get into the world. When I met John, we were both working at the Film Forum. I didn't like him particularly. And then one day, we went out for a drink, and I said to the woman who runs it, I said, you know, he's not so bad. She goes, oh my God, I can see it now, you're gonna get married. I'm like, Karen, he is so not my type. So we had to get married at like noon on a Saturday before the regular scheduled show.
What's really great is we actually showed a movie at the wedding.
Buster Keaton's Seven Chances.
Buster Keaton has to get married on his 27th birthday in order to inherit $7 million.
And then in 1985, Spike was having a screening of this rough cut of this film, She's Gotta Have It, and he invited us.
Girl, I got plenty of what you need. 10 throbbing inches.
We walked out of the theater and John said, I've seen the future of cinema and his name is Spike Lee.
Grade A tube steak.
We handed over $10,000 that we just made so he could get it done.
Green fight out. Hi, I'm Spike Lee. I'm not directing, I do this.
And it changed our life dramatically.
I became the go-to guy helping independent directors sell their films. A watershed moment came with the film Roger and Me. We made a mega deal with a studio for a documentary that was very critical of a huge corporation. Independent film was really, truly making its mark.
It's like Spike paid for my daughter, Michael Moore paid for my son.
Please, baby, please.
What do Spike Lee, Michael Moore, and Kevin Smith have in common? The man Variety calls a guru now brings us the most definitive book on independent filmmaking.
John wrote Spike, Mike, Slackers, and Dykes. It had been 10 years of producers repping, and he'd had it. He was bored. He didn't want to do it anymore. And out of that grew the idea for a television show.
Take a wild ride through the indie film world with John Pierson.
Instead of just being able to support one or two films a year, we worked with 150 different filmmakers in the course of that show.
Jump?
Yeah.
Every week, they did story segments.
As human beings, we can go to the movies anytime. Tonight is for the cows.
But we also gave first exposure to quite a few new directors working on features.
The Blair Witch Project will be an unprecedented.
This was long before they were completed films.
Most mysterious puzzle.
Finally, it's another season of Split Screen, and I'm here with filmmaker Don Ward.
Into the fourth year, John was getting a little tired of it, wanted to do something else.
So we thought, okay, what's a good adventure we could have?
Hey, what if Split Screen went to look for, like, most, you know, completely remote movie theater in the world?
Maybe it's in Fiji?
Fiji, huh?
My next stop was Tavayuni, the Garden Island.
And the gag was, let's take some American independent movies to the world's most remote cinema.
But what if the audience didn't like my film? I mean, Fiji was well known for its cannibalism. Fiji filmmaker Chowder? At last, the Holy Grail.
The 180 Meridian Cinema, and it's all mine.
Laying eyes on the front of this theater that first time was a dream come true.
Pierson? Where the hell did he come from?
A vision you had in your sleep, and there it is, and it's better than anyone could have ever expected or anticipated.
At Showtime, we found out there's at least one place left in the world where you don't need TV ads to open a movie, at least if the movie's free.
What really made the day is before the first screening, Don Suk Lal showed the Three Stooges short called Some More of Samoa.
Don't do that, I'm ticklish.
They go to the island of Rum Boogie. It's marked by every politically incorrect image you have of Pacific Island life. I have never remotely heard anything like that. This is somehow what I missed back when movies meant everything to people. That night sparked everything that's happened since.
Don Suk was moving to New Zealand, so the theater was going to close. John had this epiphany that he had to buy the theater. He came back and he got involved with Kevin Smith and Matt Stone of South Park and the Blair Witch guys, and they all were happy to sponsor him in this adventure. And then John thought, well, and wouldn't it be more a better story if we all went? And I said, not me. I'll see you in New York.
The good part is we'd all been together on the initial one-week trip. So they knew what it was, and it wasn't just some completely bizarre-sounding, faraway tropical island. Well, it was, but they knew about the completely bizarre-sounding, faraway island.
But then he brought up the idea of documenting it. I was kind of like, it was like, no!
One of the unique factors of this theater is that it's got these beautiful shuttered windows. At night, it's the greatest thing in the world to have a movie with the windows open. The breeze is off the water. You have the stars in the sky. It's not like you're in a sealed up box in a mall in America. You're part of nature even when you're inside this theater. It's free, it's remote, but indisputably, it's one of the all-time dirtiest theaters in the world. This place is called the 180 Meridian Cinema because the 180 Meridian, aka the International Dateline, passes right through the island of Tavayuni. This theater was built in 1953. By the patriarch of a family called the Dioramas, a man called Ambaran. It must have been a gargantuan task. As he always said when asked, why did you do it? Movies are good. Nothing less, nothing more. Movies are good.
There were quite a number of Indian population on the island who wanted to see Hindi movies. The place was all jam-packed, every screening. I would get a lot of friends coming to me, can I come to the movies? Of course you come. You'll have to pay for it.
The Indo-Fijian community definitely is the commercial class of this country. The country would cease to operate if the Indo-Fijians left, like some people wish they would.
The Indians think the Fijians are lazy, and the Fijians think the Indians are greedy.
Well, he's a weird guy. You know, someone coming all over from the U.S. Yeah. Setting up in the remotest island in Fiji, Tabuni, and running this rundown cinema, and he's spending money to upgrade the cinema. And on top of that, you know, he says that he will not charge any admission. I said, there's something seems to be wrong with this guy, you know?
You can keep shooting till you miss. Nope, that's it. That's it for now. Come early for the show. We'll play before the show tonight, okay?
Before free movies, the only people who could afford to see the movies were the Indo-Fijians, even for a buck.
I gotta tell you, man, nobody came for Harry Potter 2, though. What happened? Did you like it?
Yes!
How many straight nights of free movies are we gonna have now?
10!
And how many different movies in 10 days?
The Indians said you let everybody in for free. Those kids, they love the movies so much. They make all this noise. They drown out the dialogues. And I'm like, yeah.
10!
Yes!
There you go.
And that, to me, is like the peak of life.
10 and 10.
It's the only source of public entertainment. I remember growing up, where we used to go out and, you know, sell coconuts or collect coconuts and get paid so that you can go down and watch the movie on weekends.
You're coming for the show.
We used to see lots of Western movies. To Hell and Back. People love that. John Wayne used to act a lot in movies that they showed down there.
Wait, we got another one. Another one. Everyone's putting their clothes on.
I am thought of as some independent film purveyor.
Don't run.
I partly came to Tabuni to get away from that. You know, I was sick of that. Frankly, independent film, on a certain level, gets as tedious and boring as generic Hollywood film does. If you look around this island, you can figure out pretty quickly that you're not going to be showing the girl with the pearl earring.
Action movies are always very big here. Some of the American comedies, what they say, what they do, we can't relate to it. But if there's a comedy here with Bruce Almighty or Bringing Down the House.
But now you have to go because this is over. Really,
Biscuit. You misrepresented yourself.
This black woman coming over, taking over your house, things like that, people enjoy very much here.
Charlene, come on, you're not fooling anybody.
Physical knockabout comedy is hugely popular, especially if there's an element of embarrassment. Any hint of sexuality in a movie, hugely popular. But there's something even wonderful and innocent about that. I don't want to get into the noble savage or anything like that, but it's a pure response to certain really primal, basic, dumb things. I entertain with the hot chick, but I lift people up with Bend It Like Beckham and Rabbit Proof Fence. But I must add that there are probably two hot chicks we show for each Rabbit Proof Fence, if not three.
Before I came, I was kind of excited but racked with worry and anxiety. John would be fine because John would be showing movies at the movie theater and he'd be writing a book. And what if the rest of us were just miserable? You know, what would we do? I was ready to kind of be open and give up a lot of stuff, but I had a bottom line about being connected in the internet. Isn't paradise doing what you want to do? instead of me spending years worrying about why aren't I outside hiking up the mountain, which frankly, I don't really want to do it, being able to kind of relax and do what I do like to do and not feel guilty about it is paradise.
All the people here, they want to write letters. They want pen pals in America. This one girl in America, she's just like, why would I give you my address? Just tell them to email me. And I tell them, like, they don't have computers. They can't email you. She's like, what? Are you kidding? They don't know anything except for just, like, how their life is. Like, Westchester County, they go there, they get their nails done, they go to the mall. Like, there's more to life. Honestly, I am, like, the most comfortable with the small kids. Started just, like, we didn't talk at all. We would just play around. But they don't take me seriously, which is good because, like, I don't want to be taken seriously all the time. The older boys stay away. People say they're scared to talk to me or like they just don't know English. Dearest sophisticated sweetheart, in coming into this crazy world, men was not fully equipped with the necessities with what makes a man whole.
The boys, they try to be really romantic, like they write these love letters.
Never in the history of my life have I ever come across such a beautiful woman like you.
It's so funny because the English isn't right and it doesn't make sense.
The love I have for you is unexplainable. It tickles my heart and worries my brain. It has been a long
The girls all have so many boyfriends. When they say someone's dating, like date is just like, you know, the sexual whatever.
In the mirror of my heart, then I knew it was you, the one I have always been longing for.
Wow.
Love loads. Iceman.
The Fiji junket, the big adventure here, has been life-changing for everybody. I wanted a sort of a midlife crisis slash mission where the family was also involved.
So will you go take that to the theater? You can meet me there? Okay, thank you.
I'm the guy in the mosquito coast. You know, Ali Fox is going to get his family away from America and teach them self-sufficiency and teach them what really matters. And of course, things don't turn out well in that particular story.
You shouldn't talk at the beginning because they don't do that at any other theater.
Well, I know that they actually do.
No one ever listens when you talk in the beginning.
You know what kinds of movie theaters do that?
Independent movie theaters.
Yeah,
but
our
theater, if we showed an independent film, there would be nobody there. So it's the exact opposite.
Hey, guess what? Is anybody going to come to my big fat Greek wedding?
That's not like most independent films.
That's right, because it grossed $240 million in America.
Have you seen it? Oh, yeah, you did.
Have I seen it?
Okay.
What? If you think independent films are the movies...
How many people do you think stayed awake through Gangs of New York? There's about five people.
Yeah, the...
Get it right?
No, that's Neo. The other one, the...
The nigga.
Who? Morpheus.
Yeah.
We're looking for our operator who absolutely is supposed to be here, and then there's an operator who could be here, who also walked by before and said he was coming tonight as well. And we're trying to think of option number three, but there's five kids in a search party looking for Domingo. But I'm a 35 projectionist in a real projection booth, but things are so unbelievably quirky up here that I don't trust myself to run a show here. I've been down this road many times, and there's not really a lot I can do about it, so I've learned to not go completely, absolutely nuts.
Here's the search party. They're back. Okay, what's the word? Who's giving the report?
Uh-oh. Domingo is drunk.
Domingo is drunk.
Yeah.
Hey, was the buy up there? Was the Maj up there?
Oh,
he was
that
with
is
him?
So bad.
Was it grog or homebrew or something else? What do you think?
Drink
the
grog.
Drink the grog. That's great.
As always, it's great to see you guys here. Quiet down for a minute. Seriously. Please. And I always like to tell you the truth, so I'm going to tell you the truth tonight. Namaj and Domingo are both had way too much grog in Narusa. Neither one of them thought that it was important to come and show a movie to the 300 of you waiting here. Guys, we're going to have to just not have a show tonight and just come back and do it all over again tomorrow.
But you know, I figured out how to do the schedule based on your grumpy advice. You said double bill. So you know that Buster Keaton film? It's really short, it's only an hour, because that's how long silence.
It's still not 10 straight movies in a row, it's only 9 then.
Well, you're big on truth.
We have to add another movie.
Who will notice besides you?
It's just like, you lied, you said 10 in a row.
But if I show My Big Fat Greek Wedding with Buster Keaton's film, The Steamboat Bill Jr., which is only an hour, can I at least say that's 10 movies in 10 days?
No.
What do you mean you can't? It is 10 movies in 10 days.
You don't have enough O's to write that on the board.
Okay. Why don't you go ahead and run down the ones that you think it's ridiculous that I'm showing.
Apocalypse Now Redux.
Because?
Because it's going to be boring.
Put your fork down and shake my hand on a bet. Come on.
I bet you people will laugh when all the people die. And that will be the only reaction in the movie at
okay,
all. I haven't.
That remains to be seen, but I will bet you when Apocalypse Now starts, there will be 288 people in the theater.
Because it's the day after Matrix, and they like Matrix, so they'll come back the next day.
Okay.
If you showed Apocalypse Now twice, no one will come the second time.
Well, we're not showing it twice.
I wonder why.
I'm Janet. I'm Wyatt's mother. And are you Tui's father?
That's fine. Yeah,
Tui's at our house a lot of the time. Lovely. I love Wyatt's friends here in this village.
Here it's pretty raw. When I first came, I was like, oh my god, these shacks. I was just like in pain kind of from the poverty. And now that it doesn't seem like poverty to me anymore. I've sort of gotten more used to it, you know?
This is really clever. I really like this grill. This is so smart.
I feared coming here. The women are up making fires early and, you know, cooking outside, and they do laundry in the spring down in the sea, and I don't have those skills to do that stuff.
Was it spear fishing or
it is spear?
And the fish is like bright blue and bright red, and I had no idea because I'm used to it being like this color, you know, when it's all finished. Very exciting.
You know, people are incredibly clever about what they use. They don't waste anything.
Got it. Okay, my sell it. Oh!
Living here, it's seductive. It's the attention you get on a daily basis. I guess it's what celebrities face in America.
The last community day, and I tried helping with the bread. Mm-hmm. I was really bad. I couldn't do it at all. Like, I was kneading it. So that's why I don't invite people over. The sun, and the sun.
There was kind of a thing of, as a Westerner, you're not really supposed to invite Fijians in your house because they're going to steal from you.
We'll make this for you, eh?
Because nobody else wants to eat this one. All right, I'll eat it.
I was like having anxiety about, were we having a true Fijian village experience? And John said, the cinema is my village. And, you know, that's well put, I think.
Domingo is missing in action. It's become this bizarre opportunity to bring the guy we really want, who's our regular operator, back into the fold, which is really what the theme of today has been, looking for Nemaj in his green truck. I think I've got him pinned down, and here he comes. Okay. He didn't stop. No, it's Fiji style. You can't really know that an employee of yours is going to be on the job until he's there. We'll give him 5 minutes to finish up his business there. Okay, here's where you want to take it. Really, really, really slow. Slow over the bump. You don't have to hold it. You don't have to lift it. Just let's go really slow. There you go. Look, the man who's going to show the movie is right there in that truck. What?
Just to the wharf. You. Just to the wharf. The you.
To the wharf and back.
To the hole.
Go. Hurry. To the wharf and back. That'll be another
10 minutes.
You got it.
Ooh,
what's
my
Nemaj is working tonight. When he walks inside, I'm locking him in. Yeah, that's the plan. Hello. So I think what I'm going to do is call Ilya, tell him he's on. Oh, here comes the truck. Okay, here comes Nemaj. Bye. No. Come on. You're taking Ilya somewhere.
No, to Itabuki.
Then what?
I'm going back.
And then what are you going to do when you come back? You're doing the show? I don't get it. How long is that going to take?
10 minutes.
Yeah, but that's the boat was going to take 10 minutes. 10 minutes. If you want to know about how things work in Fiji, this is the front page of the Fiji Times today. The South Pacific Games, which is the biggest athletic event in the South Pacific region. They had the opening night ceremony. It went on for 3 hours longer than it was supposed to. The flag, as it was being raised, was dropped, which has led a lot of people in the country to say, oh man, the whole games are going to be jinxed now. The flag was dropped. You know, it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful place, but you know, things don't work right. Nothing really works right. The South Pacific Games, which they've been preparing for years, okay? 2, 3, 4 years. The opening night was a complete fucking disaster. Ilya, Nemaj just drove by at top speed without stopping. I'm gonna, you know, ask you to come in, okay? Get comfortable, even though you're really fast. Again, just take your time and let me know and we'll go when you're ready, okay? I'm happy to see those of you who are here, but I'm sad to see so many empty seats tonight. Please tell everybody things are normal at the movie theater. All that's different is we've got Ilya saved the day and came in to project again now, and that's a wonderful thing. Sorry. No. You gotta stop that. That trailer wasn't very good right way around, so we decided to play it upside down and backwards. This is more like it. Come on in. I was like, where was everybody? You know, you guys are late. Why don't you want to watch the movie? Listen to people laugh and get the movie.
We are going to see them now. Insects.
Yeah.
See who?
Georgia and Bob.
Georgia and Bob. Where are they and what are they doing?
Ships.
They're having what?
Yeah,
really?
Kissing.
Which?
You break it down when you were 8 or 10. Well, thank you. Why don't you go bother them some more?
Yeah, go.
Just go bother them some more.
Right, fast. Go your fastest. Tell them that their mom and dad are coming.
She's 16, and I'm not going to dictate what's the appropriate amount of sex somebody should have. But I worry about her here because she wears less clothes than everybody else, and she's exotic American. And I worry about her not understanding that. If George is really hanging out with Bed Bob, that's Nightmare John's own invention.
I think he's an asshole. I don't like him at all. But John always thought he was smart and kind of like, you know, could be better. It was kind of like a project job would take on. And you know, he was falling down drunk here one night and stumbling around. And we kicked him out of the theater. He's like by the gates. He's like, John, I love your daughter. You know, it was like, John thought it was funny. And I'm like, it's not funny, you know?
When we come home from the movies, a padlock was missing. We've been through this before. We've come home from a free movie to find our house robbed. So I immediately proceeded over here to our bedroom. This door we always padlock from the outside. So I open the door, and I turn on the light, and this is what we see. It's not a happy sight. So she went for the closet where there's usually the storage spot for the laptop computers. Janet's Palm Pilot, the digital camera, and they're gone.
They left the pretzels, though. The pretzels were in the closet. They left the pretzels.
Good news. The pretzels were not taken. But these two glass louvers had been removed from outside, so the whole thing sort of then became, well, what does the front door have to do with anything? Well, the padlock's gone. Who has a key? I have a key. Andrew, our landlord, has a key. So Janet picks up the phone to call the police, and there's two messages, and...
And he goes, Andrew, and say hi, Colin.
Colin, say hello.
Hi.
Right, he's here. I heard a bashy over the house.
Which is just the most bizarre thing in the world.
Trying to take it personally, but it's twice during a free movie.
You know, it's like, who are they going to steal from? They have to steal from us. You know, we're the rich millionaire people who are showing free movies.
Crazy rich millionaire.
Right, crazy.
These are police. Come on in. So you've just seen our landlord. Anything we should know?
Well, at present he's a bit drunk.
No.
But
okay.
But according to him, he said he did not open the door.
Oh, he did not open the front door.
But you didn't look in his car trunk or anything?
No, like...
Janet, I hate to say it, but there's a cockroach crawling up your foot on top of everything else. I might even like pick this one up for good luck. You'll just kick it out the door.
Yeah, no, I use them on
the score!
The kitchen window.
Here's your chance to show that you're like the best crack police force in the world. You're going to get a fingerprint off that louvered glass tomorrow morning, and you're going to find, you know, who did this. Okay.
Good night.
Thank you.
They're going to dust for prints.
They can do that in Tavuni.
They have forensic investigations here.
That's awesome.
CSI Tavuni. CSI Tavuni. Yeah, come on. Let's like be more specific. So now it's an Agatha Christie novel. It's like, I want everybody here to prove that they didn't do it, okay? Georgia was out.
Smoking pot and having sex, I know, I heard.
You weren't having sex and smoking pot.
At the same time?
But you were with Bob, amongst other people. So Bob didn't do it.
No, I'm sorry.
See, that helps. Now we eliminated one bad guy. That's not funny. It's really not funny.
No, he's trying to be funny.
At one point, there was a rash of like 16 robberies.
Irrelevant.
Around.
It's
not like we're the only people who've ever been robbed.
No, but we're the only people.
Apparently, there was a huge robbery down at the dive shop down there, like tanks and $7,000. We don't know if the details are true or not, but
why would they have $7,000 at the dive shop? Would they find gold doubloons?
Yeah.
All right. Secondly, you know, come on.
They just come back.
I'm sorry. What are the Europeans in Sangulu have a set schedule where they know they're known to be out of the house every time it's a free movie?
What you're saying doesn't make sense because, yes, we're easier marks, but it's not like we're the only ones.
We haven't been part of some Sangulu crime wave. That's bullshit. We've been one-offs each time because we fucking go out at the same time to show the movies.
I would rob someone just because they lie about 10 movies in a row and I had to walk 2 miles just to get to a place where I had to sit for an hour to realize that there's no movie.
What? There we go. What? You know what? You're the best. You'll keep us going. Hey, Janet, Andrew's here.
Excuse. This white pan. Okay. Could I sit down too?
Oh, please.
And relax. I popped around tonight because this is the second time this has happened, and I'm concerned.
Oh boy, that makes me feel so much better.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming over at about 5 of midnight. Thank you.
Excuse me. I had to compose myself before I came across, okay? I'm a hotelier, registered in Fiji, and I'm proud of it, all right? You've been broken into two times in my home, and that annoys me. John Pierson and Janet, okay? Back to you.
You're at a bashy?
Yeah, it sounded like a shutter breaking or a something like that. But the dogs made too much noise, just like the last time you got broken into.
The barking dogs when the last robbery occurred is strictly your theory, and it just happens to be crazy wrong. Okay.
Dogs have certain barks. They have doggy barks. That means dog against dog, or dog against someone they don't like, or dog. Yeah. But that's maybe a doggy forensic thing. But I ran across without a torch. They were
he
gone
took
already.
The chance of coming halfway across the tennis court without a torch.
Right, that's great. Very helpful.
And I made a phone call and I proved it, unfortunately for you.
I'm sorry, what did you prove with
what
your phone
I proved?
Call?
What you got broken into, with my sympathy.
You left a message. Was a response of yours to the first robbery?
Basically, because my son and I were accused of breaking into our own home by John Pearson. My son wasn't anywhere near the place.
Well, guess what? We don't suspect Colin had anything whatsoever to do with what happened tonight.
Oh,
but we really will treasure having his voice on that voicemail.
Well, we'll probably...
Oh, yeah, he was on it too, wasn't he?
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, he was.
That's great.
He was.
Yeah. Oh, I've got the fuel bill, and if it'd be okay with John, I need to check tomorrow if that's the date that we did agree on.
Okay. So this is very important to you to get paid. $311.28. Okay. It's very important for you to have this tomorrow.
I would appreciate it because I paid it.
Our second robbery in your house.
Yeah.
Tonight's robbery, I believe the total loss will, you know, come in around...
A couple of thousand.
No, Fijian, 10,000. Yeah. So I'll make sure that you get your $311.28 tomorrow. I'll make fucking sure of it!
Thank you, John. And I hope we all have a nice night.
चूकर मेरे मन को ये तूने यही सारा
Our mornings are very exciting. Oh. Is this the bus coming? I thought you said bus.
I want to ride.
Yes. Yes, let's sit under the tree with no branches.
Yes.
It's actually very dry in here.
Is that a bus?
Fuck, it's full. It's not stopping. Fuck.
5S, we're having a sermon this morning. 6A. This is about the third time I'm calling you out of your classroom. Pastor, please. Boys running after the girls.
Good morning, students. It is nice to see you looking all fresh and ready to begin another term. So thank you very much, and welcome back.
Tonight assembly, the new principal talks for half an hour. The vice principal talks for 15 minutes. It's torture for everyone. No one listens because it's so hot. Kids will bend down and hide underneath the shadow of people, and so they're blocked from the sun. If other kids do it, no one, the teachers don't notice. If I do it, the teacher's like, where's the white kid?
So the theme for this week is cleanliness. We teachers will
also try and do that. So our theme for this week is cleanliness. Thank you. Now we will end with a short prayer.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Wyatt.
Today I'm going to talk to you about traditional and modern agriculture. In the traditional days, the men, they cut down the tree using the axe. And in the modern days, the man, he is using the chainsaw.
There's the kids that are just like, oh, it's a white American. That's cool. He's showing free movies and he's from America. He has to be rich. I just want stuff for him.
Susan Goff. Can you say that after me?
Susan Goff.
All right.
And then there are people who just don't care. And then there are people who are like, why is he coming here? He should go home.
When we are reading the story.
I think I do try a little bit not to be the white American kid.
17 Laws Lane.
The phone number?
888-8888.
People just get mixed up with using
wow.
R and is, lots of things like that. So me, I just like leave it out of the sentence when I'm speaking.
Today, you said you'll buy me some juice and donuts today.
If I could speak Fijian, no one would care that I was American.
And the way he mingled with the students in the class, it was something else. Pardon me if I say that. The white children are a little bossy, you know? And he was nothing like that.
Written instructions would be use of imperative verbs.
It's like an Indian, Chinese, Japanese.
An imperative verb is commanding.
English is a bit easy for Georgia, yeah? When she feels that there's an answer that I've said that it's wrong, she puts up her hand and she gives her own opinions on the answer she has got. Because whatever she wants to say, she says it openly. And I respect her for that.
White is very special. It's totally different from Georgia. Yes, I think she acts in a typical American way.
The big problem we have here is truancy. Most of these students, they play truant. Miriam and Georgia, they would go together.
Sometimes you like school, sometimes not in the mood of schooling.
One day we just stayed home and played ping pong and ate cookies. And then we come back after school.
Did you get in trouble for that, Miriam?
Suspend from school 2 weeks.
What about you?
We went to disciplinary committee and they yelled at me. And then I just talked back to them and they give me dirty looks. What they wanted to do was just like make it seem like I was making her and these two other girls do all this bad stuff, and I could tell they weren't really gonna do anything to me, so I just took it. I told them yes, it was me, like I took all of it. Still, I don't get in trouble.
For Georgia, maybe she's coming from a school where she's had a lot of freedoms, huh? For these kids, once they do something like that, they put their future on the line, huh? They get suspended, and then we have to call their parents, and then the community look at them as bad, and then, you know, it's their future, because they will stay here.
I met this girl from Hawaii. I stuck it in her ass, and she said, hey.
I met this girl, she was from Fiji. And she said,
Leta.
She
said, Leta.
Before Georgia, I had never had an European friend. I like hanging around with her most.
I met this girl from Hollywood. She had green hair, but damn, she looked good. I took care of her, she was fine. She's so in a dig that is bigger than mine.
White and Georgia, they have adopted the Fijian way. They see things, they talk, they play. People start to love the kids. Like, by the kids, they start to accept John and Janet.
And is this like a treat, or you just eat this every day?
Yeah.
Okay, now what?
You bite it and...
For that one.
Well, you, let me see you do it.
Then put away the...
And just suck the juice out? Chew and suck?
What is it?
It's sugar cane. But you take a bite. See, look, these guys. You take a bite. You chew it around. And you
yes,
get the liquid.
I know how to eat.
Have you had this before?
No.
Tuake is a kid I will miss most here. From the minute I saw his face, I love how he looks. He is just the sweetest kid in the world, and I feel like he's added to our lives.
Mother.
Tuake is probably my best friend here. He's always here.
Tawake in the Langa side, Rosini Ilanisa, Ducha, maybe a vital be white. Ningin the Tangi Chunga and Saturn air. Go valley. Listen, a woolly. I sing a young girl and young white.
Tawake, Madame Bessani. In the song of
Tu valim be ini in itu ambe enam mondo ta ini tu ema.
Gara mana sih ambat tu?
We got three questions. You ready?
Yes.
Are you gonna run?
No.
Are you gonna push?
No.
How many movies in a row?
Ten.
Oh, you guys know everything. The first free movie night, it rocked the house. I mean, the place was packed. I knew, well, free movies have hit town with a vengeance. Now it's a battle. 7:30, I like that start time for a bunch of reasons. Mass starts at 7. You know what? Those people are going to have to make a choice. The missionaries don't care one whit about what it is we show. They just care about the fact that it's being given away for free. And the argument is they have devoted their lives to teaching these people certain Western ways. And one Western way that they've proudly taught is that there is no free lunch. You work for everything in life, don't expect handouts.
It brings back those days before when the early Europeans came over. They would give things freely to the Fijians in order to get things. Like our elders faced in those days, like they were tricked by the Europeans, eh?
I was a threat to the community, and that what I was doing was extremely undignified and was tearing families apart and could be dangerous for people walking home after the show. When we really wound up engaging in open warfare was when some of the priests got a hold of something I'd written. I was goofing around quite a bit. I joked about how I'd be happy to compete for the souls of the natives of Taviuni with my movie theater. The church took that as they took that as a serious challenge. And they started reproducing copies of this article and helping people misread it so that it would look like I was calling everybody backwards here. It went to starting another 27 rumors fed back to me from my son in Holy Cross College. You know, you write a line in the LA Times like, this is an island where Curly is God. Pretty obviously in America that was a joke. Seemingly here it was taken literally. You know, I had people asking my kids, what religion are you? Where Curly is God. Or Dad, they said that you're, you know, raping Fijian girls. Or Dad, they say you're a pedophile. What's a pedophile? Best one of all was, Dad, they said you killed a man in America and had to come escape here. Now, that one I loved. I've always loved Johnny Cash, and I just always thought, yeah, I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die, and now I'm in Taviuni. What does that rhyme with? So it got ugly.
The alarm bell started ringing. He said, I don't apologize. Everything I've written, I'm proud that I've written those things, and I'll be writing more. And I thought, here's a guy possibly is looking for conflict, or maybe that's what he wants to do to promote his book or his movies. Is this project primarily for the benefit of the people of Taviuni, or is it for the benefit of John Pierson?
If they have a problem with me being here, it's just the pot calling the kettle black. Christianity and the Roman Catholic Church have nothing whatsoever to do with indigenous Pacific culture, and nobody asked them to come here. In a place like Fiji, the whole idea of missionaries civilizing the natives is a very mixed bag. If civilizing means pacifying the warrior and cannibal past here in Fiji, great. But if civilizing means teaching individualistic capitalism to a culture that had always had shared wealth, always. So if that's civilizing people, well, hell, the church certainly did that. When we first came here, I found everything about this church powerful and moving. I think that the way they went after me without coming to me was both un-Christian and extremely un-Fijian.
For Fijians, we have to find out from people first before we can get a collective decision, especially with the Europeans when they come. Eh? We don't normally come up and say straight away because of the language problem that we have, eh? Language barrier.
Maybe Mr. Pierson should have approached the communities and said, look, I'm here and this is what I will do, and, you know, address it properly. You know, all of a sudden it was just bang, and here we go, free movies.
John is like a hurricane. He comes from far away. You know, you don't know him. To some people, there's fear.
I requested for the change of timing for his movies in order not to affect the children's education. And when people were still in church, eh? Which he changed.
I don't know what draws me back. You could say it's sort of like the zombies going back to the mall in Dawn of the Dead. My father's father was a Presbyterian minister. My father might as well have been. And it's 507 strides from the base of those steps to the front door of the movie theater. And that's exact, okay? 507. And during those 507 strides, you know, my thoughts churn every which way but Sunday about, you know, how conflicted and confused I am about all this. Well, here we go, the call to next service. Probably need that at the movie theater. See, that's the problem. We have no drum. Let's go to the movies.
Really? 180.
Merdian. Elias is totally closed up. Cross your fingers, because this is Fiji. It's not going to go routinely, I'll just tell you that.
Today we're holding the first ever student film festival in Fiji. And we have a program of about five or six films, two of which were made by us, and the rest were made by friends of ours. When we first got here, we plugged in the projector to test it, and just blew our projector. And by some miracle, we've met one guy on this island in the middle of nowhere. Sam fixed our projectors, amazing. He swears it works, and we trust him, we totally trust him. I'm sure he'll be here, maybe he's just running on Fiji time, we'll see. But what we're gonna need to do is just plug it in down there.
My main dust cloth is a Holy Cross gym class green shirt that somebody once left here. Every time I leave it out, somebody tries to take it home to wear. So
this is it. Here we go.
All right, now what do you got?
Oh, fuck.
Oh.
The camera? No, that wasn't the camera. It's still going, though. Well,
what do you mean it's still going?
I don't know.
All right, oh, window. That was not good.
No. Shit. It's probably the six, maybe the six.
Can we go get a TV now?
In a city, in an eyeball, on a rock, in a fence, where a goat was alone by himself, there was a boy.
This is yours. I fixed it.
Is there anyone from this area working for you?
Garita from Nangara. She's been working here for years. Sia, Tara Sia, is my cook.
Yeah.
Gopal's wife. She was with us at the movies.
What about the husband?
He wasn't at the movies.
Does Gopal go inside the house?
No. He's never sort of been farther than the doorway.
Right.
I hate the idea that I don't know who stole from me. It could be somebody I really like. It could be somebody really close to me. I hate not being able to trust anybody.
They're so nice to me. That's why I really like working there. I'm kind of used to the American ways. The Pistons can eat chicken from Monday to the next Monday. But Fijians, oh, only when somebody have a birthday or Christmas time.
Georgia! Georgia! What? Georgia! Georgia! Hey, wait up 1 second. Let me just ask you something.
We had a fight with her. As we were leaving the house, I said to her, could you talk to some of your Sanglulu friends about the robberies? And she thought I was accusing her friends.
This is nice. What if we have a house this high, Georgia? Wake up in the morning, you sleep forever.
Never wake up.
Whenever something's stolen, they always think it has something to do with the people I hang out with.
Me and Mirama, forever.
I got angry when they said that. I'm like, why the fuck would I go ask them? And my father just put that in. I threw my brush at him.
Keep it away from here. Keep that away from here. If you want to see X-Men 2, I really recommend getting into the theater and getting a seat instead of watching a silly fight.
I want to see my friend hurt. Him and the wife, they're different.
That is so big, huh?
This is a big night out for you.
The wife, she smile and talk, go here and shake hand.
Tia tells stories about when she came here and she was a teenager and she was kind of drunk. And she said something came out of the screen and she screamed. You know, she thought it was right next to her.
She like cuss.
Okay, this is the bullshit I can't take. Look, go in or get out. I'm always a little distrustful of people who put up this perfect front. I would probably enjoy being a better person with less conflicts. But if they're when they come up, it's just I can't remotely see a reason to cover them over. And that's one of the reasons that I'm not, you know, exactly a perfect fit in a culture like this. As my kids say, they think you're insane. Just wait. Stay right here.
He thinks he's so tough, but look at him. These Fiji boys could break him in half. He's scared on the inside. He just doesn't want to show it. He wants to be tough Uncle John.
Okay, 2, 3, 4. That's it, stop.
John is an American. They're sort of pushy people. But they respect John, I know. It's quite amazing to see how he controls it, you know. When he says something, people listen.
All right, now who's been right here? You two were right here, you three were right here, and you two. You're the five, okay?
Even though he's bad tempered, he's got a good heart in showing us three movies.
Sorry, you might not make it today.
He doesn't waste time talking this way or that way. He goes to main point of the conversation, that's it, and then he walks out.
Well done.
But I like him for that.
He don't waste his time talking for bullshit.
Everybody must have been. Are you ready?
Yes.
Name another movie based on a comic book. Any movie based on a comic book. Up there.
Spider-Man.
Spider-Man is correct. That's an excellent answer. There are a lot of other answers, but you have won. an X-Men 2 poster, and congratulations to you.
John is happiest sweeping the theater, cramming the last body into the seats, putting on a good show. This is so the essence of who he is.
Here we go. Ilya, if you're ready, X-Men 2.
Came down to John Pearson's place. So my wife was walking in there, you know. Andrew came across and I said, "Hi, Andrew."
Andrew, our landlord.
And what Andrew said was this: "Hi, fuck you, black motherfucker."
I should probably explain a couple of things. Your wife, Sia, after the robbery, we asked her to stay at the house last night while we were at the free movie. And then you coming to watch over her, frankly, because she was there alone. Who knew? Who knows who's out there? So, continue.
And he was saying, "You want to see an Australian cut off your balls?" That's what he said. And I said, "Hey, Andrew, we are living in a harmonious place, man. This is Fiji." He said, "Fuck you." Then he went to his place and brought a cane knife. I was standing there, he came for me and welded the knife 3 times. And we went to the place and they didn't take it very seriously. They said, "Oh, maybe he's drunk. Just forget about it." But all those words that he said about my mom, he doesn't know how I was brought up from childhood, how they struggle about me. And that word, it really aches me in my heart. So as a Fijian, we are all born warriors, see? And that blood of our ancestors is still fresh in our bloodstream. And I told him, "I never want to see you in the road, and I'm gonna drown you in your blood."
He has to be charged. I will insist that he be charged also. Yeah. Put the knife away. He doesn't have to be in a pool of his own blood, please. I know I sound like the, you know, American, you know, the balanced, let's use the law. It may or may not work, but we will file charges. I will back you up.
I'm just waiting for this time. When John and Janet will leave the place, that will be the time I will take my revenge. Honestly, I've crossed my heart.
Andrew came up and he said, "Look, something happened last night. Colin and I were walking by." Were definitely words with Gopal. And then he recreated the robbery. "I was asleep and I heard the noise."
He said, "Fucking spare me. I don't want to hear this."
Right, but listen, before you get all crazy about it, the guy's a psycho, all right? But frankly, Gopal, as far as I'm concerned, is the number one suspect.
Janet.
I'm sorry, John.
I'm sorry. I agree. The guy's a drug dealer. We all know it.
We don't know.
Okay, wait.
Sia doesn't know it. Sia doesn't admit. Will not admit to
me. No, she's in denial. She knows he's a drug dealer. She's in denial about it, okay?
No, we don't
the
know
point, look, okay, you've had, you basically, it's like you're playing Clue this morning.
No, listen, stop.
You have
I
so many suspects.
Exactly
you have so many
like.
Suspects.
That's exactly what it feels like. I was thinking the same
the
thing.
The dive masters in Tabunia Estates. Because they have a boat.
But
they can get it off the island.
Yeah, exactly. But you just shut up for a minute and don't be so drama queen. Everybody's pointing fingers at everybody else, but Gopal's doing a lot of finger pointing. You know, he's making a lot of noise. He's creating a lot of diversionary.
Gopal is also saying that somebody pulled a knife on him. That's not noise. That either did or didn't happen.
Maybe it's like, let's create it over there so it takes the heat off of me over here. You know? What are you doing?
Finding we got more movies.
All right. But anyway,
I mean,
John,
life
I'm just
goes
telling
on.
You, so the thing is,
movies go on.
Yes, they do. They do.
Vijen, hey, it's John Pearson. No, busy is the wrong word. Listen, yeah, just a little minor robbery totaling about 14,000 Fijian dollars worth, that's all. Can I quote you? You would call him one ungrateful sons of bitches. Good, okay. Okay, starting tonight, I'm gonna charge 10 bucks, okay? The one thing I wanna leave for these ungrateful wretches of Tabiuni, you know me, I wanna show Jackass. So what did you find out about that print? Hey, Vijen, I call it the Jackass test. If you pass the Jackass test, you're coming with me to America. And you're gonna run a studio, okay? Thank you. Okay, bye. Come on in the side. Okay, so this is the 311 from the other night,
yeah, and
right?
Excuse on that on the other night. I know it wasn't probably the right time, but we weren't both in a good mood, I think.
What happened last night? I mean, I don't know,
yeah,
but what happened last night?
At two times that night, he threatened to kill me with a cane knife, And this morning at 6:30 in the morning, he came back again and threatened to kill me with a chop me up, okay? It's a pastime, you know, when people get angry, all right? Yeah. Nice comment, all
is
right?
There,
we don't
is
have
there
a.
Stuff between you
well, yes,
two?
There is. He's a known drug dealer. He has a record as long as your arm. You know, it was not what person I'd recommend to be security for you.
There's one thing that we really do know. The dogs, which we don't like around anyway, are useless to secure our house. What? You don't agree?
I don't agree.
Oh, thank
the
you.
Dogs are great except when there is a robbery. So, okay, let me just. Okay, so you never said anything nasty to Sia. Did you happen to call him a cunt?
Don't think so, not to my
no.
knowledge.
So you didn't call no. anybody a cunt?
Oh, I. Look, there was it was a very heated exchange for about 10, 15 minutes.
But if you called somebody a cunt, it was him.
Well, actually, he called, he said something like, fuck your mother. My comment back was, then your auntie and your cousin too. It's sort of a Fijian yeah. thing, all right?
Now, the thing is, Sia does matter to us,
yeah.
okay? You agree that Sia is lovely?
Correct.
Should be treated respectfully?
Yes.
Do you think it's between you, Sia and Gopal, right, the three of you, giving an account of something? Do you think that it's just automatic that anyone would believe you first?
I don't, look, I've given my statement, you've got their statements. You make up your own minds, okay? All right? Hey?
We didn't come home last night.
We don't know what the deal is. We don't know if she's going to show up tonight. I think she's making a big statement that's like, you know, we were angry, but we'll see. All the people here in Waikiki are talking about her, you know, and it's like they're wondering what she's doing roaming around all the time. And I don't know, the whole shame factor. And,
yeah.
You know, I don't know if you can be a good influence or not. I don't know how wild you were when you were 15.
My mother would be wild. Yeah. Really mad at me if I'm just roaming around.
Yeah, well, yeah. We're not happy about it. I don't know if you want to go look for Georgia or not.
Georgia was the first European friend for me to experience being there with her parents. The way she talks to her parents, it's very new to me, because we don't talk back. Yeah.
You see that girl at the corner? She hates me.
Which one?
Got to come home tonight. If I can't immediately pinpoint her, then I will send those 10 kids who seem to follow her every move. Watch your heads.
One of the other mothers, she actually pulled me out of the movie because she wanted to talk. She was concerned.
About her?
About both of you.
Why? What'd she say? We got gang raped? I heard that.
No, she didn't say that.
Oh.
She wondered why you weren't with us last night. And it was a big thing, I think, for Fijian to come up to me and talk about parenting.
Tonight or last night?
Tonight. But I explained to her that you've been very nice in our home and respectful and helping.
That's why you want to kick her out?
No, it has to do with your behavior, Georgia. Why Mariama had to go is because you were behaving so
badly.
And
also because
my
friends are the ones that steal all the stuff from our house.
I never in a million years suggested that it was your friends who committed the crime. I thought you're the one who has friends in Sangulu who could help us.
Fijians aren't that stupid. They're not going to steal computers, bring them to the village like, look what I found. Obviously, people will ask questions. Where'd you get this?
Oh. That was the way to answer the question the morning that Mom raised it. Not to scream your head off.
You're the one to talk. I didn't yell.
Yeah, you did.
You did.
And you spazzed out.
I spazzed out after you threw a brush in my face.
Actually, that was before.
Oh, so you threw the brush in my face.
Because you spazzed out,
because I spazzed
yes.
to calm me down.
In this case, I think you did the spazzing out. You went kind of nutty. You know, we only knew about Sete because Sia told us about him.
Did you bring Sete into Waikiki today?
No.
I don't know who he is.
Sete, the guy who stole our
Sete.
Tire. Sete. Sete. The guy.
set.
I'm really trying to get the word out that I'll pay a reward to get some of this stuff back.
I said the first time. What are you talking about? I'm obsessed with these pronunciations. He stole our spare tirade. Did I say that right?
No.
I mean, what's the point? Why bust my chops on something stupid like that?
Because I don't want you to make a fool out of yourself and you go, hey, Senti.
Georgia, he stole our tire. What does it matter what the fuck his name is?
If you want to go talk to him, might as well know his name.
He stole our tire, Georgia.
Relax.
No, really, think about what you just said. I don't want you to make a fool of yourself mispronouncing his name.
Georgia, everyone says you guys are walking around by yourself with different boys every night. You want to be embarrassed like that everyone thinks you're a whore or that you're saying a name with a wrong pronunciation? Which is more worse? More worse. That's good English.
More better, more worse. Whatever, I'm not a whore. I know it, and that's all that matters.
I told this
I don't
woman
care
tonight that
people.
I trusted you, Georgia.
Our reputations are golden.
Georgia, your situation is so different than Miriam's. You're going to be gone a couple of weeks. You're out of here.
Why are you blaming me for the way people sit?
I'm not blaming you.
There's nothing
you.
I can do.
I'm not blaming you. I'm just saying you have
to be
conscious of it.
And why does it matter so much?
Well, what about
do you think Miriam should care?
What about for Miriam, who's going to be staying here after we leave?
Are you saying that I'm giving her a bad reputation?
I'm saying that the two of you are apparently thought to be running wild right now. And that you're going to be leaving, so, you know, it'll be a funny story for you. But she's going to be here, and it's not going to be just a funny story for her.
What are you saying? It's my fault that people spread rumors about her.
No.
What does it matter what people say about you? Like, in America, it happens all the time as well.
I like staying with Georgia. It's different living in my house because my mother, she always said, look after your brothers and sisters. I have to do everything. I think Georgia's family is happier than my family. When my parents fight, they always punch each other. For Georgia, parents, it's like they just talk, then finish. They never fight each other, punch, no, slap, no.
She always says that there has to be something bad about everything. For her, the one that she came up with was like there's scars on her face from when her father was hitting her. She just kind of was quiet after that.
It's too long.
Halfway.
It's scary.
Georgia, nearly finished.
No. I want to have the same tattoo like she did because I think it's cool. And when she left, they said, oh, I remember the tattoo. There's the tattoo on George's back. I have no other close friends that is so close like her.
We lost our passports as part of that robbery, and they've got to be replaced or we can't leave the country. So I've got to go to Suva, to the U.S. Embassy, and get new passports. But I get to see Vijen, my man at Damodar Brothers, our distributor here in Fiji. He's come up with a Jackass print.
And then, you know, what I'm saying here, the opening shot of Arnold Schwarzenegger coming out of that balloon, you know, as a Terminator, when you look at the guy physically,
you know it's been 11 years since the last one came.
Right. But he's got a pig's bladder in his heart now or anything like that, right?
Well, he's got a nice trim haircut, not like yours.
You give me a hard time every time I walk in here. It's like, oh,
what do you expect? Every time I see you, you're in a different haircut.
Should he run for governor?
Why not? If it will help his movie career, why not?
Yeah, there you go.
He's a movie guy, I'm a movie guy. But then, John is a hard man to please. Even supplying him movies wasn't enough. He's constantly on my back, on my emails, on my phone. Many a times I don't answer his calls. He will be persistent. It's hard to say no to John.
Even though I haven't seen Jackass, we are all convinced that this will be a hugely popular film.
I'll be very frank with you, John. I think it will be a disaster for us.
And why is that?
Because over here, it'll take more to make the people laugh than just people doing stupid stuff on skates and things.
Really?
And you know, you expect them to laugh.
Not in Tavuni, it won't. But if my kids are wrong, I'll ship them down here to be your slave labor for the next year, and I'll go back to America without them. That'd be great.
Jackass? What do people not like about it? The,
that it has no
the
story.
Stupid things?
It has no story. It's a treadmill where they keep doing one stupider stunt after another.
That's awesome. That's the best. I'm happy there's no storyline. If they add a storyline, then it would suck.
That's so true.
I'm standing up there tonight, Wyatt, and crediting slash blaming you and Georgia for showing this film.
Fine. And that's all you say tonight.
Sister Rosemary walked by today and she goes, what are you showing tonight? I'm like, don't come. I said, this is not for you, don't come.
Tell her this.
She goes, yeah, I only came once. I said, well, you come see enough? And she said, in Maine, Manhattan this year. So maybe it was this year. And she goes, and that was a good one. That was a good one. I'm like, yeah, that was a good one.
Why am I evaluating our success or lack thereof?
With Sister Rosemary.
By what the fuck Sister Rosemary came to see. Yeah. As I go back to America, I will never have any contact with any Catholic priest, any sister, brother, for the rest of my life.
I had a lot of problems with it, and it wasn't just all the putting stuff up your butt humor, which I don't really like so much, but it's like here where people don't have anything, people have nothing, and there in America they have nothing better to do than just like destroy things. I thought that was just really horrible.
It's not that they have nothing better to do. It's so much fun.
No, it's decadent is what it is, you know. Would you like to do that stuff? You think you guys would like to try that kind of those stunts? You think? You want to set a firecracker to your dick? Why, you don't think these kids are going to do that? They always imitate. Oh, come on, they come out of all the movies imitating. They always do Jackie Chan and they imitate everything.
They never hurt themselves, though.
Just because they haven't seen anything like this yet. You think now you'll try some new stunts?
You just said that to him. He said no. Don't you listen?
We went there.
If you could take some kind of high road on this, this is just like, you know, you're going to make yourself a total fuddy-duddy. I mean, really, seriously.
You know, I don't have a problem with that, John.
Jackass is just the Three Stooges all over again. What's the difference?
It's always been a big conversation all year about what we're bringing.
Movies don't do anything to hear.
Movies totally affect people. People talk about being kind of a group hypnosis. You're in the dark together, you know, you're kind of in this.
And
so it affects you. It affects you emotionally. I mean, that's what's so great about movies.
Yes, this movie sucks. You can just leave. You don't have to be bored.
Images are powerful that way. You're a kid. You have no idea what it's going to affect you. You don't know what you're going to be still thinking about in 30 years.
Yes, it doesn't affect me now, but in 20 years, Jackass will affect me.
Well, you don't necessarily have the...
You don't know what you're talking about.
Well,
I actually have more experience in this than you do.
The media has a very strong impact on students.
I don't get it.
Kids, they just follow what they see. So you have the Fijian values, you have the Western values. Now we have the media culture coming in. It's a culture on its own. I'm not really criticizing the Western cultures. We need to progress, eh? Kids going to the movie is helping the community because there's hardly any social life around here.
Because he said it's a high fever for a couple of days and
dengue. Okay, let me do it, okay?
Nothing's wrong with me except just right before we were coming here, I got bit by a dog. So I don't know if somebody should look at it or not.
No, you just watch it. See, Janet's jealous. Whenever something's wrong with me, she needs something to
maybe
be wrong with her, you know?
In.
You know anybody like that? Extreme chills, joints, bones, severe aching. My wife really thought I should come in. We were wondering if it could be dengue.
From this high fevers, we usually have to take a blood test.
Yeah.
Because of the high incidences here. Yes.
Okay.
So your dad has dengue fever. They'd be happy to admit him to the hospital. It's a matter of wherever he's more comfortable. With his fever, it was pretty scary, frankly. They call it bone-breaking fever. Georgia?
She's in the kitchen.
How's your cupcakes okay?
Oh, fine.
Okay, so, all right, fine. You know, I love Georgia.
Yeah.
But John and I both admire her spunk.
Yeah.
She's the kid I wished I was.
I got headbutted.
Yeah, okay. No, as long as it's not some weird reality. Okay. But from early on, she was never easy with me. In our family, well, who looks more powerful? I picked John, too. There's a certain definite whim factor with me.
I'm going. I'll come back later. Bye.
You know, we blew up George's world, and we gave her this great experience, but it's coming to an end now.
We'll just walk home.
No.
Why?
No.
Why?
The answer is no, and it's time to go.
Wow, you should be a rapper.
Let's go. Come on, every law, Rosalind, Richie, back in the car. Miriama, if you're staying at our house, the time to go is now.
No, we're not coming. Fuck, I'm not going.
Miriama, you better come now if you're coming back to my house again ever.
Why are you trying to be an asshole?
I'm not. It's just
you
enough.
You are. You obviously, all you want to do is try to be an asshole and show you have more power than me by doing this.
Your father's just really sick, and I need to, like, deal with him and just have everybody in the house.
If I'm not there, it's easier to deal with him.
It's been an exhausting
week.
I'll
tell you, I'll be home.
Georgia, I don't
care.
In
2 hours.
No. You're just acting for the cameras here, and I really don't like it. It's time to go.
What? Acting for the cameras?
Yeah, you're acting for the
you're
cameras.
You're the one to talk about it.
No, I'm not.
What is
I
this
said
that
I'd
you're
be
doing
here
now?
10.
You're the one acting, not me.
I
you
said,
said
I'd
never
be
done
here
this 10.
Before.
Don't even. Ugh.
What? What?
I'm not acting for the cameras.
Mm-hmm.
If anyone is, it's you. You're
no.
trying to show you're a good mother.
I said I was going to pick you up at 10. I came to pick you
up
at
10. You
said
you were going to pick me up because you wanted to sleep. You
yes.
said I couldn't walk home.
Ah, Rosalind, how come you guys are staying out of it? You just don't want to get involved? Do you have an opinion?
If you're letting her stay, and then I'll just have to stay with her.
Sit.
But if you're not, and then we'll have to all go home.
What if I give you until 11?
Then start
which
walking.
Which is what you wanted. No, then I'll pick you up.
11:30.
11 o'clock.
11:15.
No.
Yes.
It's already. 11
in the
is
morning.
Good. No, 11 is good.
11, yeah, right.
Fine.
We'll be at 11.
Okay.
I'm a good negotiator. I knew she would give in.
She's got a big personality. I mean, things could be far worse. She's not like a heroin addict turning tricks in Detroit, you know? She could not come home for weeks at a time. She could not be decent to everybody else. I had enormous freedom when I was her age. You know, so there's part of me that's like, you should have fun when you're young. It's painful because I'm a parent and I don't feel like I have instincts for it. For me, the hard part is the pressure as a parent to supposed to know, like, what's okay, when I don't know what's okay.
Go to the back and see if you can hear me. And can you hear me?
Easily.
Loud, or should I speak quieter?
You don't have to boom it out like me. I'm a little loud for this whole culture, so.
I'm happy all these people are here today. You are the true movie fans of the 180 Meridian Cinema, all three of you.
You're on your own. How are you gonna get them in?
And then trailers, then I talk.
No, the trailers are gonna get them in, right?
Right.
You gonna tell Elia what to do with the trailers?
Yeah.
Okay, that's about it. What,
okay,
Elia?
So I'm running the show.
This is the first show. I'm sick as a dog. I have a really high fever.
So I'm doing the...
Wyatt's in charge. And
I'm
he's
in
got,
charge tonight.
So. He just pulled some new trailers for you, and he's going to tell you which order we'd like them in.
This one or this?
No, only these three, none others.
No others?
Just these, yeah.
I'm charmed that he could go up there in my stead. I'm just tickled by that kid.
You can go inside. You two, I-16, can't come in.
I think he's cut from the same cloth as me.
You're 16?
But better, way better.
16. I'm not 16.
He's got tremendous empathy for other people. That's where he really puts me to shame.
Yeah, that's the only reason I shouldn't do this. I'm younger than half the people that I have to get out. All you have to go.
But he would never back down from something that he thought was true or important.
1 year, not month, year.
This too is true of his sister, but she's got far less judgment in how to apply her spirit than he does.
Okay, hello? I'm talking tonight because my father is sick, so he can't talk. Tonight we're showing Apocalypse Now Redux, and tomorrow we're showing Kante.
I hope I've shown him that you don't have to fit in any particular box.
Hindi film, it's action. So enjoy the movie.
I think the sky's the limit for him. I think he's going to do great, great, great things. He's wise beyond his years, and he's a delightful kid.
I'd kill myself if I had his job. Independent films, I think, are boring. Having people send me their movies for me to see if they're good or bad, like he does, I would hate it. Having my own TV show, like he had, I'd think that'd be cool. But if it was on IFC, I wouldn't do it. If it was on Bravo, I wouldn't do it. I don't see any of myself in my father. I do have a short temper, but I'm not as bad as him, and if I ever am, that would suck. My dad, he didn't come here to be relaxed. He came here to show free movies and to people to like the free movies. He likes to know things. He knows a lot about Fiji because he read all the guidebooks.
but he doesn't really try to like fit in with the Fijians. He doesn't try to learn Fijian. He just tries to be the same as he always is. He always saying how he doesn't like to be in America, but he likes his American way. He wants to be like he is in America. I don't know why.
One game each. I start the third game though, right? No.
You started every game.
It'll be a good sport, but you can start the third game.
I don't want to. You need more help than me.
Nope. You must start the third game.
He wants to do his own thing. He wants, like, movies, movies, movies.
No do-overs. Okay.
But he cares about the way people see him.
Gee.
It's not like I think he's like, making the world a better place, but I don't think he's destroying it either.
Uh-oh. Don't say.
Like, I have pride just in general for, like, everything he does, like, he doesn't do like the 9 to 5. He doesn't wear the suit every day.
Thank you, Lord.
I respect that. Like, I don't want my life to be like that.
I'm not feeling it.
Maybe it's just because he's the only father I have, but like, I'm glad it's how it is.
Woo! Because it was best 2 out of 3, I'm still undefeated, right?
Yeah, you are undefeated.
Thursday morning, a woman came up the drive saying her husband needed to see us right away, and I walked over just not far from here, behind this Tavuni Estate sign, and there in the bush, not far from the road, were my two black cases. Some stuff was missing, but there were the laptops, and they were in Pelican cases, so they were, like, dry. We still don't know who did it, so it's not like, oh, happy days, life is simple again. You know, it's still, like, could be anybody, could be any of the people we know.
Mirama is going to Suva to live with her boyfriend.
He's a bad boyfriend. She'll be stuck.
When me and her became friends, things did change for her. After something significant changes in your life, it's not like you want to just go back to how it was before then. The only thing you could do is to leave and go someplace new.
I can't believe I'm going.
Yeah, me neither.
You can't believe I'm going?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
Yeah.
I want to go to America, especially in New York.
Bye.
Goodbye. I'll miss her a lot. If not, I'm going to climb that
tree. And sit on it.
Last one.
Yeah.
Bye.
Have fun.
I think America will be much more fun.
I don't think so.
Yes.
You can come and see one day.
I will.
Okay. I'll miss her.
I'll miss everything here. But I'll have to come back.
On behalf of this community, the big Vinaka Vakalevu, to you, Mr. John Pearson, your beloved wife, Janet, no dictionary can jot down the words of how well you have served in the community. Georgia and White, you broke the barriers of the racial groups. You counted us all in your family.
Oh, fantastic. It's been so wonderful to actually discover that this is the greatest village and the greatest group of people, not just anywhere on Tabuni or anywhere in Fiji, but anywhere in the world. I just also want to thank all of you who have come out to the movies as well. You know, it was really fun for me to show the free movies, but if people hadn't come to see the movies, it would have been a complete dud.
We know there isn't financial wealth in this country, but the wealth of the heart just been greater than anything we could buy.
When you first come here, they're like so warm and friendly, and it's supposed to be so great. And then you think that that's actually not true. But now that we've been here longer, it actually is true. You know, there are layers to it.
And they're kind of funny in the dark, but they're okay.
You know, I'm an old dog. The impact on me here couldn't remotely rival what it has been for my kids. In the end, I just really enjoyed being far, far away in a really, really, really different environment where there were still enough touchstones that made it feel like I had cut loose, but not in a completely lost in space sort of way.
I'd be bored back in America. In Garrison, it's a big deal if you have five kids at your house. I have five kids at my house every day here.
These are gonna be the real movie fans coming tonight. They don't even know what they're seeing, but they're gonna love it. Oh, that's no rush at all. Okay, good. Tonight's film, nobody's probably heard of it. It's by a comic named Buster Keaton. It's a silent film, which means there's no talking. I don't mean for you guys. You can talk as much as you want, laugh as much as you want. I'm showing it because it's one of my favorite all-time movies ever made. This one tonight is for me. But I really hope and think that you guys are gonna really like it too. Near the end of this movie, there is a big cyclone, just like Cyclone Amy, which hit Tabuni in January. Buster Keaton gets blown around a little bit, like I know many of you did. A few buildings fall down, like I know some of your houses did. I hope it's funny to you now because it's 6 months later. So Elia, when you're ready, let's roll it back up, okay? Let's go. Okay, here we go. Steamboat Bill Jr.
When something is positive, for me, for the audience, for everybody else, and lifts you so much, you almost feel like it's a cure for cancer. You almost feel like it's a cure for all that ails you. It was like nothing else mattered anymore. All would have been right with the world.
people are going. Are they coming back? Will we have any other free movies again? When they leave, for us, it will be a memory for a lifetime.
Thanks for coming. You like that? There's our Indian heritage right hidden behind the upgrades.
Oh!
I don't really know how to sum this up, except to say, I will be missed, I think we will be missed, I think the free movies will be missed, except by those who will be waving goodbye with great delight.
You do.